Hello, my name is Grace. Today I read the story, The Outside Dog. Marisol wanted a dog. Marisol lived with her grandfather and Puerto Rico. Their home was in a little village on the side of a hill. There was a big mango tree in the yard. I think that is the mango tree. It's weird. There, neighbor up the hill was Donna Elvira. She won a little There, where they brought their rocks. The neighbor down the hill was a fisherman named Nando. Sometime in the early morning, Marcel went fishing with him. There were many dogs on the hill. There were strays. No one wanted or took care of them. Marcel said always wanted a dog. But grandfather said they are feels and takes, and who knows whenever a dog come into the yard, grandfather chased it away. Fed, he yelled, screamed. One day, grandfather and Marcel came home and found a dog sitting near their house. He was sinking brown mud with party eyes and big brown ears. Grandfather chased him away, but that evening, the dog came back. When the Marisol saw her grandfather was not looking, she sneaked out the petted him. There's a cute here. I have to put on this. Marcel said, grandfather, I told you not to pet the dog. they have fields at and tickets, and who knows that, but Apple to this one dog's not said Marcel look grandfather said there is not a fear on him. So may I pet him? Asked Marcel. You may pet this one, but only this one, and don't feed him a thing. In this, said grandfather. Once you feed a stray dog, he never goes away. That dog is cute. Later, when they were eating, fork, chops, and potatoes, the dog came and sat very quietly outside the screen door. Grandpa, do you think he is hungry? Asked Marcel. Of course he is hungry. Evers, stay a stray dog on this hill is hungry, said grandfather. If I worried about that, I would be feeding 20 dogs. Grandfather peeled the leftover bones onto the plate. What are you doing with the bones? Asked Marcel. Throw them in the garbage. Of course, said grandfather. Why don't you give them to the dog? Asked Marcel. Grandfather sighed. All right, just this once, but not here. Out on the road, away from the house, I don't want him to think that this is his home. Here's the leftover bones. They walked to the road. The dog followed when grandfather dumped it. The plate of bones, three other dogs came running. Scream! Grandfather shouted, let this one eat. Vet! Thank you. How much story is here? There is four chapters here. There you go. I will read only until this chapter. Color of Kanto. Only this chapter, and next time I will read the second. Grandfather steeped the dark coffee in the doorway. Marisol petted the dog. He is short of nice looking for a mutt. Isn't he, Grandpa? He's okay, said Grandfather. I don't think he is all mutt, said Mosso. Maybe 90%. The rest of him look like fancy dog. If he is part mutt, he is all mutt, said Grandfather. Marcel parted his fur. Oh no, he said. She said, now I see a couple of faces. We better get him a fill collar. Cosa, said Grandfather. Who over heard the petting? The flea collar on the stray dog? Oh, Grandpa, please let me buy one with my money. Uncle Cook gave me for my birthday, Grandfather sure did. I soap is you can buy what you wish with your own money, he said. But don't think this dog is going to like having a collar around his neck. I had a dog, and he didn't like the collar. At Donna Elvis's store, there were few collars in two sizes, medium and large. Is he a medium dog or a large dog? Asked Donna Elvira. He is short of medium, large, said Marisol. I think he is more medium than large, said Grandfather. Mother nodded. I think so too, she said. When they go back to the home, the dog sat very still while Marcel put the fur collar on him. That's odd, said Grandfather. I didn't think he would like it. He loves it, said Mother proudly. At bedtime, Marcel said, the dog is in the yard. Abuelito, is it okay if he sleeps there? I don't see any way to stop him, said Grandfather. There is a full room, so he will not be in the dark, said Marcel. And when it rains, it keeps dry under the mango tree. Ahem, said Grandfather. Grandpa, he's asleep, said Marcel. I guess he feels at home, said Grandfather. Marcel's eyes brightened. At home? I didn't say it. This was his home. I just said he feels at home. Now go to bed, said Grandfather. There is the dog. Grandpa, Muscle called. You forgot to kiss me good night. Marcel heard the floor creak. The grandfather got up and crossed the room in his bright feet. Sleep well, Marie, he said. Marcel smiled. Dad is what I say when I said good night to Pancho. Pancho, said Grandfather. Who is Pancho? My dog, said Marcel. I named him Pancho. The dog name is Pancho. Yesterday, I will read only this much. I have read two chapters. It was fun and bye.